just keep your grubby mitts off, 'cause if it goes, it's gone for good. So just keep your bloody grubby mitts off, 'cause if it goes, it's gone for good.
In the same way, commercial journalism is accountable to its owners, whether they're shareholders or families or corporations. And increasingly in those newsrooms, what matters is not what is editorially important, not what you need to know as responsible citizens. What matters is what holds eyeballs, what generates clicks, what creates revenue, what is best for the business. Now, I'm not suggesting that all commercial media is bad, quite the opposite. We need it. It's often good, and it's always important to our society. But commercial media exists to make money. Public media exists to serve the public. ABC is always good. But let's stop to think for a moment what Australian journalism would look like without the ABC. There would be certainly no Four Corners, no Dawndale investigation, no inquiries into match fixing in cricket or corruption in the Queensland Police Force, or scandals in the horse racing industry. Instead, we'd have another commercial equivalent of 60 Minutes. Now, 60 Minutes is a fine program, but we'd be indisputably worse off without Four Corners. Nor would we have 7:30, only another current affair. We'd see very little coverage of Aboriginal affairs on commercial radio and television. Or minority groups, unless of course they're African gangs supposedly terrorising this lovely city. And because we know political interviews turn off viewers and lose commercial news advertising dollars, the serious and worthy political interviews are left to the ABC. Now, as much as I respect Alan Jones and love Hamish and Andy, none of them are substitutes for AM, The World Today, or PM. World, they would not survive.
I almost want to make a business case for the ABC. There is a very thriving ecosystem and a healthy trade that goes back and forth between the ABC and the commercial networks. The ABC is tantamount to the research and development wing of those commercial networks. Routinely, and I think this is the right thing, those commercial networks harvest the talent and the skills that the ABC have sown the seeds and cultivated all of those people that the commercial networks are able to then literally capitalise on that development. I think that's the right way for it to be. I think this healthy exchange, where many of us go back and forth between the ABC and the commercial networks, is something that keeps our culture very healthy and strong. Because I don't believe that there's an opposition between public and the private sector. And I think something that we really learnt from marriage equality, it was actually a real education for me, was the importance of finding common ground with people on both sides of politics to defend the middle ground and to expand it. Because at this time, I think, in the history of the world, we sense the precariousness of democracy, and what we need to do now is shore it up, and that means keeping the voice of the ABC strong and broad, and using all sides of politics to help us to defend our ABC. Just to use my own career as a case study, I started out at the ABC in D Generation. A few years later, that went across to Channel 7 in a show called The D Generation Goes Commercial. That then morphed, elements of that then morphed into fast forward. Then Gina and Jane and I started Big Girls Blouse, which was on Channel 7. That sort of morphed into Kath and Kim, which went across to the ABC, became a mega phenomenon, the most successful television comedy in the history of Australian television. Could not have been created anywhere else other than at the ABC. Then it skipped across to Channel 7 for a while, and then more recently, repeats were played on Channel 9, where the ratings were once again gangbusters, and revenue was gained for the commercial sector. So my career, as you can see, plus, you know, going across from doing ABC to films like Babe and Happy Feet, which have generated a lot of cash. So I think if you were to rip or out the ABC, or just even to damage it so significantly that it can't contribute, from the commercial perspective, from a sound business perspective, it's bad business. The ABC is good for business. It's a place that is not as risk averse as the commercial networks can sometimes be.
Sincerely though, I want to thank ABC senior management who have trusted me to speak today. But I do resent the fact that we even have to be here at all. Why are we here?
It is our ABC. It is not the government's ABC. Not the Labour Party's ABC or the Greens' ABC. It is our ABC for all Australians, and that is the key message for the federal election whenever it is next held. And one of the things that I think it's good to remind our parliamentarians is that I've never met a parliamentarian that has 80% or more. Only the ABC can attract that level of support, and that's why we have to work to ensure that from the Prime Minister down to every candidate in the forthcoming election gives a commitment to our ABC. Thank you.
Barry, good to see you. I know you want to talk about your film, you've become a film star recently, but can we just really talk about the importance of the ABC to you?
Look, one thing I need to put in, there are four great Australian iconic institutions which are under threat at the moment because of budget cuts. CSIRO, the Bureau of Meteorology, the Australian Electoral Commission, and the ABC. So there are four. But the ABC is the most important of all because it's integral to our knowledge of the world and it's integral to the way that democracy works. And of course, one of the reasons that politicians hate it is that the polling indicates it's the most trusted organisation. And the word trust that catches in the craw of politicians is the ABC is trusted. They are not.
I want to pay my respects to the ABC elders, past and present, especially John Clark and Brian Dawes. And their narrative, which I remember marvelling at when I heard it, when they said, "This is what we do, Brian. It's jazz, the harmony of the voices. And this is what the ABC does. It's the harmony of the voices."
We need to defend it and we need to grow it. Not just no cuts, but make it bigger. And there are some states in Australia where you wake up in the morning and your choice is between a Murdoch newspaper and a Murdoch newspaper. And if you want an independent alternative, you go off and read The Australian. I fear that happening. I fear that happening to radio, to TV, to our online platforms as well. And I can speak from personal experience to say I worry about waking up in the morning and having John Faine go through me like a dose of salts. But I worry much more about waking up one morning and finding that John Faine or someone like him isn't there at all.
We will make sure the ABC is never privatised. We will make sure the ABC is funded to do its job. We will make sure that we are kept well and truly honest by people like John. I agree with Adam. You know, it doesn't matter how well you know your stuff, how much you're prepared, how much you think you're over it. Oh my goodness, the butterflies you get in your stomach before you go on John Faine, or before Fran Kelly or Lee Sales or any of them. It just makes you think, oh, you know. And you've got to feel that. Every politician has to feel that, and that's why we need our ABC. You need to keep politicians accountable. You need to keep the system accountable.
Where would we be without our ABC? That's why we stand here so proud. It's not for sale, it was built to last. That's why we need to say it loud. Where would we be without our ABC and everything that it means? It's brought us drama, docos and comedy and great investigative teams. But there are some who'd like to see it gone to suit their commercial end. But it still stands for truth and reason, and that's why we'll defend. Where would we be without our ABC? We'd make it stronger if we could. So just keep your grubby mitts off, 'cause if it goes, it's gone for good. So just keep your bloody grubby mitts off, 'cause if it goes, it's gone for good.